Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. My name is Ria and you are watching Escape in Reality. I have been living in Ireland for the past 5 years now and I have studied here. I have worked across multiple jobs and now I work at Google. Today I wanted to talk about all the challenges I faced initially when I decided to move to Ireland. So stay tuned till the end of this video because I will teach you, show you how you can navigate all of it and get the most out of your study abroad experience. I think the number one challenge that I faced was identifying the right college and course for me. So a bit of a background about myself. I did not have prior work experience in India, so I came straight out of my undergraduate program. I also did sociology, so it was definitely not related to a business school. And I was very confused because I wanted to go study abroad, but I didn't know what was the best university or the best course I could opt for. So I decided to speak to a lot of people, reaching out to them. I was able to find one or two people who had been here. I reached out to them on LinkedIn, but I got like very upper level information on what the program was. So I decided finally on MSc Marketing. So I know that there are still a lot of students who are now applying for the 2025 batch and they are facing similar issues. They have excellent academic records. They have the right, approach. They have decided that they want to go to Ireland, but they are really struggling in identifying the right program for them, the right university for them, and the right college. And I think this can be a game changer if they can speak to the right people who have experienced all of this throughout. So today I'm partnering with a startup which is called Uniflix Study Abroad Community. They are dedicated in providing one-to-one support to students by connecting them to people who have moved to Ireland and have been living here and have experienced the whole journey of coming from here, from India to a new country. And they are dedicated towards helping you across the journey, so building your profile, shortlisting colleges and the courses, applying for loans if you need so, which I also needed, and I wish I had received the right kind of support for that, as well as finding accommodation, which is a major crisis here in Ireland. So they are deeply committed to it, and they can also put you in touch with the right people who have been through the same course or been through the same college, and they might be able to link you up and provide you the right information. What really sets Uniflix apart is that they have a partnership with nearly all the universities in UK and Ireland, and that significantly increases the chances of you getting an admission there. And what is the best part is that this is a student-led initiative, it's a student-led community, which is why the entire process is free of charge. All you need to do is make a refundable deposit of ₹799. But if you use my code, which is RHE300, you basically will get 300 off that $799. So you only need to pay $490. And once you finally sign the offer letter and your college and university and course is confirmed, you will get a refund of this deposit that you made of $499. Also, you can book a free session with them by sending them a WhatsApp message with my code RHE300 again, and it can be a one-on-one consultation that is free of cost. So I'm attaching again my code here and the number that you can reach out to book a free consultation with them. So if you are considering Ireland or the UK as your study abroad opportunity, do reach out to Uniflix. This is a great starting point to get ahead in the process, and you can find out all the information and the links in my description box below. And do not forget to use my coupon code RHE300 to get the discount on the initial offer, or if you're booking the free consultation via the WhatsApp link, you can send them this code again and they will be able to know that you came from my channel, and that will help me as a creator also grow and be able to expand my channel further. The next big challenge that I faced here in Ireland was, of course, the cultural shock that you receive. If you don't have experience and if you have lived with your parents for the longest time, moving to a Western country is definitely a different experience. My life in India was very different. It was very protected. I had to, I didn't have to cook for myself. I didn't have to clean for myself. Usually we had the privilege of a house help, or, our parents were able to take care of us. And when I moved here to Ireland for the first time, I had to learn everything to do, on my own. I was suddenly responsible for ensuring my fridge was fully stocked in case I wanted to make food or dinner. I had to make sure my laundry was done in time if I'm going to college. I had to make sure I'm not running behind on my academics. So it was a lot of balancing between, household chores, grocery shopping, making sure you have all your documents, your resident permit, your PPS number, everything sorted as well, which was something that I did not do earlier. So this was a big culture shock for me, because here they expect you to be able to take care of yourself and be able to do all the tasks. Other than that, of course, being able to adjust living with people who come from all sorts of backgrounds. They may be from your country, but from a different part, or they may even be from another country in the world, which is a very conflicting culture or very different from you. And you have to find the right way to come together and live peacefully. The next big challenge that I faced was adjusting to the weather and climate. I come from Delhi, and the weather is far different here in Dublin than it was in Delhi. It rains on most days here, but we have great summer. So like, if people are not used to that, then it can definitely be a big change to be, you know, seeing it rain and be sunny and be cold and be warm in the same day here in Dublin. So you should always carry a jacket and a rain jacket, rain sheeter, wind sheeter to be safe here, because you don't know if it's sunny and next 10 minutes it can start raining. So that is something I am still struggling with 5 years here in Ireland. The fourth would be, of course, missing your family, your friends. You slowly start missing out, you know, on big events. You are staying a bit far away from them. Even though it's just 14-15 hours flight, you kind of tend to miss major events like weddings or, you know, celebrating holidays with your family. And you may have a strong community of friends here, but you will still kind of miss spending time with people at home. And you still feel like, oh, I wish I could go back on special holidays and be able to celebrate with them. But with time, it gets easier. And you also find people around you here. You build your own community, your own friends, your own circle. So then having to spend this time with them here becomes a better way to start, you know, getting out of that phase of loneliness and homesickness. The fifth major challenge is, of course, revolving around jobs. So when you finish your academic journey and you decide to, you know, step out into the job market and find something that you like and is sustainable, and, you know, you want to work in that field, it takes time. You also need your visa and sponsorship from the company after a certain stage. So, you know, you lose motivation. You sometimes don't get the job. You have been interviewing for a long time. You apply daily, but there might be days that, you know, it just won't work. You just won't get the job. There, what I would recommend is like taking help of your network, of your peers, taking help of people on LinkedIn, reaching out to recruiters, reaching out to your college, job cell that works there. They basically help you find different roles, identify what are the problems in your CV, and help you like improve all of that. And it takes a lot of sustained effort and motivation to be able to finally land a job. So that was, I think, the biggest challenge of all, that you have studied here, you have spent all the money, you have done well in your academics, but you still can't find a job. It happens. It just takes time and being able to identify the right course, the right college, all of it, and then stepping out into the market. It needs to all come together. Once you land a job, life gets simpler here. You are able to finally start living freely. You don't have to live in the fear of, you know, still being a student, still looking for a job. So these were all the challenges I faced here. And I feel the 5 years have gone by really quickly, but they have also taught me a lot. I have changed various jobs. I started working here for the first time, so I got my first job here in Ireland, and now I can say I'm really happy with my decisions, and I'm happy that the course I did and the job I landed eventually, they are all connected. So this is why I will emphasize that choosing the right course and the college is really important, and also speaking to people in your industry is very important to understand how your study abroad experience can lead into your professional journey. So thank you for tuning in. Do like, share and subscribe. I will speak to you again. And thank you so much for tuning in.